Okay.
For amazing views in Brazil.
Plus Santa Claus.
Plus Santa Claus. That would be the title to me.
I haven't seen a person living since the first video of Santa Claus. And the kids. I take that back. The kids in Amazonia, that was definitely in a town of sorts, a city of sorts. The last two, nope, this is where the birds stay. I've seen more macaws, toucans, ants. I've seen all their homes.
Ants.
Yeah, there were some ants.
I didn't say ants.
See, because the last person you're gonna pay is attention.
Hi, I'm Gabi.
And I'm KD.
I'm from Brazil.
And I'm from the US.
And today.
I am going to be looking at more Brazilian cities.
Today I'm bringing five cities, and as usual, one city from each part of Brazil. One for the north, from the south, southeast, northeast, center.
Game of Thrones, like, I see.
Something like that. Tá pronto?
Tá pronto.
Tá bom. So the first one will be Gramado. Gramado is a city in the south of Brazil, in Rio Grande do Sul. O
Rio
Sul.
Grande do Sul.
That's the name of the state.
Tá.
Tá bom? Enjoy.
Is Christmas their only thing? Like,
The city is very famous because of Christmas time, from October to January. You can go to the city and visit, even that is not Christmas time. But Christmas is like high season for Gramado.
Okay.
But they have like parades
For Christmas.
For
Okay.
Christmas. Nothing to talk about Gramado.
It seems like a great Christmas city compared to what I know about Rio for Christmas and Christmas that is in your face in Brazil that I see. This seems more like traditional what Americans are used to Christmas, which is to say it is more European Christmas. So it seems like everybody that came to Brazil from like Germany and those European countries ended up in Gramado and brought all their traditions. They're wearing full European garbs. It looks like that city I showed you in Helen, Georgia, where they do that similar type of thing. It seems like a good experience, especially considering it's going to be warm. So if it's Christmas time and it's warm, it's like they're hot, but you know, I'm enjoying the show.
I never been in the city during the holiday time, but I've been in the city in a normal time, and it's nice. They have good food.
I believe it. I thought that I was going to be getting a more general overview of the city and not just like Christmas.
Just the Chris. Okay,
So I just only
fair.
see Christmas. Do I know more about?
Gramado.
No, I don't.
I promise the next cities you'll be more general.
One of us plans, another one.
Cut the show.
Oh no, though, this is going in.
The second one is Ilha de Marajó.
Ilha de Marajó.
It's in the north, close to Amazonas, Belém do Pará.
Got you.
Okay.
Oh, that's very cinematic. Extremely cinematic. It looks like Pantanal. Just that one shot. João Paulo. This looks like the same type of houses in the 90 Day Fiancé.
Sim,
Tom, Tonkatinho.
a palafita, Jequitibá.
Jequitibá.
Don't think it's a Jequitibá.
No. You can definitely tell it's the north. Sloth? Pidgey. I didn't say anything.
One thing about Marajó Island or Ilha de Marajó, they didn't show in the video. They have a part. It's not cow, buffalo, buffalo. They raise buffaloes there.
This is a much better video of showing like how the area is and what the city looks like. I could tell that is it close to the Amazon or Amazonia based off of, you know, how much the use of rivers, trees, the type of houses there are in that area. It seems like growing up there would be just, you're outside all the time. Like, if I didn't know that PlayStation 5 existed and I lived in this area, it would be tons of fun, you know? Because everybody's playing with each other outside because, you know, you're outside, you know? And things can be real fun when you're just in nature running around like as a kid. It's perfect for that. There's a lot of kids in the video. You can see a lot of that. There's like, of course, not a lot of technology. Also, lack of cars and roads. It seems like it's more where transportation is boats and using the rivers because it's so much, which is cool in itself. I would like to visit a place like that or in the north, and it seems very interesting.
The only thing about Ilha de Marajó now, it's like, even that is a very tourist place, the people there living there, they always some type of struggle because things difficult to get there. It's not the best place to live because of that, but I think that it will be very interesting to visit. The next one e Chapada dos Veadeiros.
Chapada is like...
Can be, but Chapada, majority of the place that is plain. You have a mountain, but it's plain on the top.
Yeah, like, okay. Phew. Okay, so no, that doesn't mean that. Chapéu is what I was thinking.
Ah, okay.
Like
no.
The top.
No.
Hat.
Chapada dos Veadeiros in the center of Brazil. Never been there.
Tá. It's beautiful. Very cinematic.
That's what I'm saying, the Chapada.
I got it.
That is the valley moon. Because it looks like a moon and the type of the rocks. But they have a lot of waterfalls and this type of stuff. Hiking.
I got you. I wouldn't trust that bridge, but that's just me.
A little mosquitoes, probably.
Bertha. You said what part of the country?
The center.
Center. So when you say center, how far from Brasilia?
Not too far.
Okay.
I think maybe 2 hours driving.
2 hours, yeah. Okay.
Normally people that visit Chapada dos Veadeiros, they have a base like in Brasilia.
Tuki tuki.
Maybe it's the waterfall that they record José Inocencio.
Definitely. He climbed that one.
I won't go. Too cold.
The water?
Every time there is a waterfall in Brazil, the water is too cold. I don't like it.
Nice.
And this type of places like we have in Brazil, like north and center, they still have some indigenous native Brazilians, you know. So still living there, and some of them you can visit.
I got you.
Depends.
It's a lot of waterfalls.
But basically, it's like when you visit a national park like that, because it's a national park, you have a lot of hiking, waterfalls, and this type of activities.
Okay. This seems like this is a park. Is it associated with any city like before? Like the other two are cities. Majority of the time you're showing me cities. This is just
a park. Brazil. Good question. I don't know.
One of us plans.
Let me Google. Shut. They are part of the state of Goiás, but they don't say that it's not a type of city. It's no city, maybe now because it's very tourist, it's like the city is Chapada dos Veadeiros, even that it's a national park.
I got it. It seems nice. People who like nature and outdoors and wants to hike.
That is not you.
You keep trying to put this on me. I'm not saying I'm against hiking. You know, I'm good with hiking and hiking in those areas, especially with those type of views. I would definitely rather hike there to see those waterfalls than to hike just for hiking, to see another tree. That doesn't really make sense to me. But for a view, yeah, I'll hike.
Tá bom. The next one is Jalapão.
Jalapeno.
Jalapão.
Is it like pão?
Jalapão,
Jalapão.
Jalapão. City that belongs to state of Tocantins.
Tocantins.
Sim.
That's
not Tocantins. Tocantins is a city. Tocantins is a state.
What state is Tocantins in?
Amazonas.
Brazilian Jeopardy. Where is this state located?
Northeast.
Nordeste.
Nordeste, sim.
All right, let's go. You pick some really, like, cinematic things. Like, the drone shots in this are ridiculous. Except the first one. I think Santa did that. I thought that was cacao for a second. I really did. I'm starting to see things. I thought it was cacao. definitely getting Jakichi vibes. This is the same area. Could be the opening for Hennessy. I seen the shot. I seen that shot.
Hiya.
Yeah, could be.
Man, the camera is really good.
Dude, Brazilian would have been on a 2004 Samsung.
Everybody knows the place because of the dunes.
Sand dunes. Mm-hmm. Close to the other place that you said where they have the water in the dunes?
Closer than Rio, yes.
Okay, yeah.
And
yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, swimming pool in the middle of nowhere. And the water normally is warm because it... I don't know the name. It's really clear, so it's beautiful.
Red dirt. A lot of red dirt in the north.
But in the south, they have some type of that dirt, too.
Georgia?
Muito. Muito. That's it. Dent. Fim. So what do you think about Jalapão?
It's a beautiful place. It looks like a lot of shots from Hinesset. But also some new stuff like the flatlands. Having those type of mountains, it's very similar to the west United States. So like Texas, Arizona area. But it's completely dry there with that same type of terrain. This one has that type of terrain, but trees. It looks beautiful, just like the other ones. Again, don't know if there's a city anywhere near this place, but this is a national forest too, or a park.
The name of the city is Jalapão, but I think that they have a type of...
Population one?
No. Okay. I think there's more than one person that live there.
Because I didn't see any homes or...
The place closes there that has a type of hotel, Maybe it would be Palmas. It's the capital of Tocantins.
Tocantins.
Uh-huh.
State.
Uh-huh.
Palmas is a city.
It's the capital.
The capital. And Jalapão
is a city.
Is a city.
Uh-huh.
Of which we just looked at a video of, but we didn't see any people in the city.
Yeah, no. The last one would be Capitólio.
Capitólio.
Capitólio is a
Minas Gerais.
Sim, Minas Gerais. How do you know?
I can read. You read.
Okay, Minas Gerais, yes.
Nice. People. Okay, that's a start. Very clear water.
I have a picture there.
Oh, you've been here?
Mm-hmm. Twice. It's nice.
For Instagram photos?
Yes.
Of course.
But it's really beautiful. I like it.
The Blue city. Lagoon. I think I've seen the picture you took here.
Probably. So what do you think about Capitólio?
Like the last seven videos, they're all very scenic. Think that they're very beautiful and would make for great Instagram posts. The water's very clear. I saw more people. Definitely a touristy place where you have more boat tours to go towards these scenic areas. Didn't really see a city.
Question. What would be a good video for you to understand better the city?
I'm not passing judgment on the areas that you've shown me. If these are cities in Brazil in which people live, I don't see where people live. Like, this is like, okay, you want to show me cities and you show me Atlanta, but I just show you like Stone Mountain Park.
Ah, okay.
And it's just views of Stone Mountain Park that is in Atlanta. Do I know Atlanta? No, I know Stone Mountain Park.
Okay, I got it.
Definitely going to retitle this video, Amazing Views of Landscape Areas in Brazil.
Okay, it's a good one.
I think they're all very beautiful. And it shows that these beautiful views exist throughout Brazil, whether you're in north, northeast, central in Brasilia, or the south was just Santa Claus, but Minas Gerais.
But I think that majority of the times when people think about amazing views in Brazil, they automatically associate it with like Rio de Janeiro.
Depending on the view, like natural views, and when you think of like attractions or monuments. Monuments, yes, Rio de Janeiro. Why? Because of Christ the Redeemer. But when you talk about amazing natural views of like waterfalls maybe, or forests, or rainforest, Amazonia, Amazon. But to know that places outside of just the Amazon exists with still these amazing views is nice.
Okay.
It's definitely worth seeing and it's beautiful things, but it's not like a city that people live
in. Okay. Okay. Fair.
But thank you for showing me this. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. Okay, Okay, so if you have more suggestions of amazing views or cities in Brazil that KD React, go ahead, put here in the comments below. And I really hope that you enjoyed this video and like this video. And if you like this video,
like the video,
subscribe to the channel,
and turn on the notification bell.
And see you in the next video.
See you.
Kiss, kiss.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Beijo.